And people, you know, we get really triggered by language and words. And when my kid came home and was, you know, saying like fucking dick, fucking dick, fucking dick, he was little. He was little. And my kids are now 13, yes. 15, and 18. Okay, they're not aggressive anymore, and they don't call me names anymore. But you know, back in the day when I was learning all this stuff, that did happen. And so yeah, we went into like, you know, we got silly and like, oh, did you call me a funky duck, right?
Yeah.
And you know, and he sort of, no, fucking dick. And I said, oh, you're calling me a funky duck. I am not a duck, you know, and like, you know, sort of quacking or whatever. And, you know, and eventually he broke and started laughing and we got giggly and whatever. But so, yeah. So there's one other time, there was a time when one of my kids were, so he was really upset. I forget what it was. Oh, I knew what it was. So he has an earring. He's had it since he was very young. So I won't divulge how old he was when this happened, but it was a while ago. he's had an earring for a long time. So he had taken it out for a while for some reason. I don't know why, but he wanted to put it back in and he couldn't get it in the hole. So he asked me, I don't know why me, because I don't even have my ears pierced, and my husband did at one point, but that's a whole other thing. Anyway, so he asked me, can I help him get it in? Okay. So I'm like doing what I do, trying to figure it out. And it hurt. Right, because it had been out for a while, and so I kind of, you know, I said I'm gonna have to kind of push it through. There's some skin there. I'm gonna have to like push it through. Yeah. And it was like fine or whatever. Push it through, and he had this like tube of like ointment that we used to moisten the back of the earring, right, to slide into the hole.
Yeah,
and he threw it in the bathroom. He said you retarded pussy. And then he threw the ointment on the ground and the top plastic top like shattered all over the bathroom floor. And he like shocked himself and he like looked at me and I was like, retarded pussy. I was like, that takes the cake. And he just like busted out laughing and we just started laughing together. And now it's become like his, you know, his brothers know whatever. And so we laugh at like, that was the worst one ever. And everybody cracks up. But like the situation dissipated and we were able to like reconnect and laugh and move on. And now it's like, yeah, retarded pussy, whatever. But I could have like taken that personally, right? How dare you call it, you know, whatever. I mean, where would I have gotten?
Right.
Like how would that evening had end? How would it have ended up? Right. Me acting like a fool on top of him acting like a fool. Right. It's like, it's one thing for a little kid to be acting out. It's one thing for like, you know, a 40-year-old woman to be acting out. Right.
Yeah.
So I would say parents, we're our children's behavior. I'd say, hey, you know, a flipped out kid and a calm parent is a good scenario. A flipped out kid and a flipped out parent is a much worse scenario. So rather than focusing on how to not get your kid to flip, let's figure out on how to stay calm so that we can approach our flipped out kid calmly and help move them through.
Yeah.
That's all right. That's admirable, right? I mean, you tell these stories of how you're able to turn a situation around, or, you know, I tell the story about the retarded pussy. It's like, oh yeah, well, I don't want a kid. I don't want my kid to be calling me names. I don't think that's okay. I don't like it, but I also don't get confused by it.
Great, right? Distinction.
I don't think he really doesn't like me, or he thinks I'm a retarded pussy, or even knows what that means, because, well, it doesn't even mean anything, but you know what I mean? So yeah. We can't get confused.
Yeah.
So I think people really actually at first get a little bit scared, like, oh my God, this is like crazy stuff you're talking about here. But the reality is, and the way that I work is like, look, there's a lot of stuff going on behind closed doors that we don't talk about. Mm. And shame likes darkness. And we need to open the doors and open the windows and let it in and join together and say, yes, my kid called me a retarded pussy and I survived, right? and I'm still a good parent. I'm still proud of my work that I do as a mom. And he's still an awesome kid. They're not mutually exclusive. So we get to share things, because when we share them, we can actually find solutions. And when we pretend they're not happening and we hide out, we start acting out. And that's when we end up in like the, you know, acting out parent and acting out child. And that's when the world gets pretty darn ugly.